And their usual Pro Bowl regulars like Tyron Smith, Zach Martin, and Dak Prescott have all missed significant time due to injury, like we know. So, Shannon, did they get this right?
All I heard at the beginning of the season, they absolutely got it correct, was how many Pro Bowlers were on this roster. Skip Bayless told me every day for almost six years, since 2014, only the Kansas City Chiefs have drafted more Pro Bowl players than the Dallas Cowboys.
I think it's over 10 years.
Over 10 years? It would actually be
2010.
Which makes this even more egregious. So what you're telling me, so let's see. Wolf Hunter, Pro Bowler, Jalen Smith, D-Law, Aldon Smith, Don Terry Poe, Everson Griffin, Ha-Ha Clinton Dix. All those guys. And then you got Zeke and you got Tyron Smith. I get it. Tyron Smith has played about two games this year. He's out. Shouldn't have made it. Zach Martin has missed six games and left early in two other games. I get that. But what about Amari Cooper? What about Zeke? What about Wolf Hunter? What about Jalen Smith? What about Tyler? What about D-Law? I want to know, Skip, and I've told you all year, these guys have underachieved. Now, if you tell me, are they system guys? Because you say it's the system. It's Mike Nolan's system. So are you telling me they're system guys? Because there's some guys that supersede any system. LT could have been LT in a 3-4 or a 43. Bruce could have been same because he played in both because Wade Phillips was a D coordinator. So I just need you to hear me. I just want you to tell me. What are they, Skip? I keep telling you, you in Pro Football Focus, every year they rate them the most talented football team. Talent isn't worth a damn if you don't perform. Have they performed? No. That's why they are where they are. I've been trying to tell you this, and now I finally got confirmation. There's nothing but, Skip, you know what? Anytime you get anything, you get a hotel room, Mr. Sharp, your confirmation that your number is such. You get an airplane, your travel. Mr. Sharp, your confirmation is such. You need confirmation. I needed confirmation because if you'd have had Pro Bowl players, you could have said, see, it's the coaches. You got Pro Bowl players. No, you don't, because you're not worthy.
Interesting. So, wouldn't it be something if my Cowboys won the NFC East and played a home playoff game without a single Pro Bowler? Wouldn't that be something?
Look, now, I don't want people to think that the Pro Bowl is the end-all, be-all, because every year people get selected. Skip, how the hell Evan Engram with one touchdown? Skip, it's offensive that an offensive skill player makes the Pro Bowl with one touchdown. Hendrickson, Skip, you know Hendrickson. Should have been in the Pro Bowl. Chase Young has been fabulous. Cam Jordan is fabulous, but they have not played this kid. Don't be talking about, well, next year be his turn. No, no.
You didn't answer my question.
What?
Wouldn't it be something if my Dallas Cowboys won the NFC East and played a home playoff game with zero Pro Bowlers?
No.
Wouldn't that be something?
Wouldn't it be something if you don't make the playoffs this year? Wouldn't it be something the Dallas Cowboys?
What if we do?
But what if you don't? I believe there's a greater chance. So what are the odds? Are the odds in favor that you do or you don't?
Definitely in favor of you don't.
Okay.
But we'll see.
I'm going to ride with those odds.
Weird things happen in 2020.
We already got do on. You want to whip us some on it?
No.
Okay.
No. Weird things happen.
They happen already. You won five games.
Okay. So, obviously, if Ty Smith stays healthy the whole year, he's in the Pro Bowl, right? It would be a done deal because it's a reputation sort of acclamation where people just vote. They just blindly vote.
Offensive linemen, they can't get stats. They don't catch touchdowns or rush touchdowns, sack the quarterback.
Okay, if Travis Frederick had not retired, I'm pretty sure he would have made another Pro Bowl because he was right in the middle of his prime when he was forced to retire. Okay, Lyle Collins. I can't say for a fact if he had been healthy all year he would have made the Pro Bowl, but I would have given it about an 80% shot that he would have made the Pro Bowl. Which brings me to Zach Martin. Obviously, he should have made the Pro Bowl, period, end of story.
Skip.
He started 10 games. I'm sorry, he started 10 games. That's enough. Pro Football Focus ranks him as the second best guard in football. I still rank him as the best offensive lineman overall in all of football. If 10 games, 10 out of 16, so that's 10/16ths of the season. It's more than half the year. If you started that many games, you should be in the Pro Bowl.
So are you basing it on reputation? Because they don't have a 1,000-yard rusher. They don't have a they don't have a 3,000 or 4,000 yard passer. Mm. They don't have 1,000 yard receivers. So how are we gonna get Zach Martin? So what has he done to say, you know what? I understand that he's been an All-Pro basically his entire career. Mm-hmm. I understand he's been a Pro Bowl player basically his entire career. But this year, and see, that's the problem that I have, because a lot of time people get, you know, you get grandfathered in. You've gone so many times and you just look, oh, Zach Martin, yeah, let's just write him in there. Oh, this guy's just right. No. Mm. When you look at scouts, so if that's the case, Zach Martin, so why is Zeke struggling?
Mm. Well, he's only 1 out of 5, right? And if you throw the tight end in there, he's 1 out of 6, right?
Interesting.
Want to bet that he's dominated his position? I know we can't break down film of the right guard yes. every Sunday, but I will bet you he has dominated the way nobody has dominated.
I think the thing is, Skip, is because he's missed time. Because you remember, he went out, what, like the second series against Washington with that concussion. He has 2 games like that. So I think he's what, missed like 3 or 4 games, and he's been out. And now he's out for the rest of the year. So he's going to miss 6 games total.
Which brings me to my quarterback, who obviously is not around anymore. Dak Prescott went down against the Giants in the first game. Unfortunately, if Dak Prescott were still there throwing, I don't know that the record would be any better, but they would be throwing at a much higher clip and a much higher success rate than Andy Dalton can throw. I never said Andy Dalton was Dak Prescott. He's pretty good, but he's not Dak. So what would be happening with my 3 receivers? You don't think one of them, if Dak were still upright and healthy, you don't think one of my receivers would be in the Pro Bowl? Somebody would have made it.
Skip, the way we do this, now if somebody goes, if one of your guys go, so that means you got to take off D-Hop. You got to take out Devontae. Mm-hmm. You got to take out DK Metcalf, mm-hmm. Justin Jefferson,
yep.
and probably Calvin Ridley is probably first up. Now, what happens if Julio's healthy?
Mm. Well, he's not.
Okay.
So Calvin Ridley would have been gone, or Justin Jefferson would have been gone. If one of these guys, and again, Amari's on track. If he has 2 big games to end, he'll have his best season ever.
Skip.
But they're 5-9.
You do realize Justin Jefferson mm-hmm. just broke the rookie receiving mm-hmm. yardage record yep. by Randy Moss.
Okay. He had a good game Sunday, but the previous 6 games by Justin Jefferson, I dare you to go back and look at them. They weren't very good.
Skip.
He hit the rookie wall halfway.
He's one of 5 receivers in the history of the NFL mm-hmm. to record at least 6 100 yards receiving games.
Okay.
I wish I had a rookie that could hit the wall like that.
I wish I had Dak Prescott throwing to CeeDee Lamb all the way home for 14 games. It would have been unbelievable what would happen. You could already see it coming. I had 3 potential 1,000-yard receivers, and I'll say with Dak, at least 2 of them would have already be over 1,000 right now, and they would be Pro Bowl candidates.
And guess what, Skip? You would. You probably have all 3 of them, mm-hmm. but your record wouldn't be much better.
I doubt it would be, but they would have much better Pro Bowl
credentials. So you want stats?
No, I'm just saying that's what would happen. These are the facts. They're not the stats. They're just the facts of what would have happened. My defense, on the other hand, has been all-time deplorable, awful, disgusting, stomach-turning. I can't defend anybody, but DeMarcus Lawrence had a big game this past Sunday. He finally came alive.
But not enough of those.
Okay, I got it.
You think he's had a better season than Hendrickson from New Orleans?
No, he has not. And Aldon Smith got off to a hot start for the first 6-7 games, but then he hit the midseason wall because he hasn't played in 5 years. He came back to life on Sunday, and maybe he's got enough life left down the stretch that both he and D-Law are going to start wreaking more havoc against Philly and against the Giants.
Skip, you've been around this a long, long time. You see guys every year. I don't know how not one of the Tampa linebackers, one guy's like 3rd in the league in tackles, got 8 sacks, all these tackle for losses, and he didn't make it.
Devin White.
Yeah, so we go through this, Skip, but to sit here and say that the Cowboys should have, based on what we've seen, no, they shouldn't. You know good and well they shouldn't have not one. They shouldn't even have a 1st or 2nd alternate to the Pro Bowl. Mm. Who?
Mm.
Because has Cooper had a better season than Calvin Ridley? Honestly, Skip. Has he had a better receiving season than Calvin Ridley? No, he hasn't.
Calvin Ridley had a good season on Sunday against Tampa Bay. He had one in the first half. He had a good season.
Yeah, the dude is on pace to catch for 1,400 yards.
Yeah,
and you
caught 163 yards or something.
Let me ask you a question: Is Amari on pace for to catch 1,400?
No, he is not.
Okay.
But you know what I love about this conversation? Is that my team is going to be unhappy with this because so many of them have been to the Pro Bowl before. You just listed a whole bunch of guys.
13. 13. Coming to the city, 13 guys have been to the Pro Bowl.
And none of them are going.
None.
And that will motivate them Sunday against Jalen Hurts and company coming to Jerry World. It will continue to motivate them as they go up to play their ex-coach, old 8-8 Jason Garrett, in the season finale at the Giants.
You do realize they got a couple of Pro Bowlers on that D-line, though.
Yeah.
Old Fletch and Brandon Graham.
Okay. Good. Good. Bring them on. We got it.
Okay, we're going to talk a bit more about that game in a bit, but I actually want to go back to the NBA starting tonight. Will LeBron and the Lakers pick up right where they left off in the...
Go.